fans of all ages, welcome to Art Battle Toronto!
We'll be your host this evening. I'm Tanya Casol-Gouveia, and this is my dashing co-host and co-founder of this year's event, Art Battle, Christopher Pemberton! So happy to have you all here with us in this amazing great hall, as well you watching and enjoying from home. Thank you so much for being here. Who here has been to an art battle before? That's a good number. Who's my first timers? Okay. Chris, do you want to tell the first timers a little bit how this works?
All right, you are in for a treat. This is live competitive painting. We have three rounds tonight. Each round is 20 minutes long. In the first round and the second round, there'll be two groups of six, so 12 painters in total. You will vote for your favorites in the top two from the first round, and the top two from the second round will paint for a second time in what is always the highlight of the night, the third round, going for the cash prize, going for the title in the third round. It's always very exciting, but that is what we have for you tonight, and of course, you can take these paintings home because they're all up for auction.
Yeah, it's actually like such an amazing thing because you'll actually see the art being created in front of you, and then you might have it on your wall above your mantle. Everyone's got a mantle here, right? You have a nice place to hang some art. Yeah, you'll have a story to tell. You have your parents over. Oh, look, I got this art. I saw it made. Before we get into announcing who is painting for us tonight, I want to introduce you to our very special DJ extraordinaire, DJ Shiro.
Slow tornado of our appreciation.
Did you get a copyright on that? Slow?
I don't know. That was coined by somebody many years ago, but it is definitely the way that we view our battle. You go around in a counterclockwise motion, always moving so everyone can see what's going on. Also, we love to see and share your stories on Instagram. We are at Art Battle Toronto. On our Art Battle Toronto page, you can also see all of these artists highlighted with their Instagram accounts and work from their studio. But here we are, ready to go. Round number one, we're going to count down from five. When we get to one, we're all going to scream, "Let's paint!" And this session of Art Battle will be underway. Audience, are you ready?
Hello everyone and welcome to Art Battle Toronto. My name is Morgan Booth and I am here with the one and only Ariel Hosseini. She is an Art Battle previous champion a few times, I think. Now Ariel, welcome to the stream.
Hey Morgan, thanks for having me and thanks for the shout outs.
Always love having you on. It's always so much fun to get your insights as a previous competitor and just like that insider knowledge.
Insider knowledge. You too.
I have painted at a few art battles in my day.
Awesome.
All right. For anyone who is just joining us, Art Battle is live competitive painting, and we have 12 artists that are going to be painting across the night and three rounds of 20 minutes each. Here we have our first round with our first six artists. All of these artists have competed in Art Battle previously, and then we will have another six for our second round, and then the top two from each round will move forward into a third and final showdown where one artist will be crowned the winner of tonight's event. Here we are with Nazreen Askar. She is a tried and true Art Battle star. She's been painting with Art Battle, I think, at least for 10 years, and she just absolutely loves to rock the easel. She's painted in multiple cities as well, and always a pleasure to have Nazreen up at the easel.
Yes, I think I actually competed with Nazreen on my first art battle. What an amazing painter, really and truly.
She just infuses her work with so, so much joy, and she really just brings such a wonderful energy to the easel. And speaking of someone who brings wonderful energy to the easel, Randall James is also an artist who brings just so much joyfulness and performative energy to his art battle competitions.
Yeah, also an amazing competitor. As you can see, he's already laid down tons of color. We have subject matter, and it's been like, what, 2-3 minutes?
Right? Like, he's got flows of color going on. He's got his butterfly drawing already mapped out. Like, he's, like, definitely a few minutes ahead of the pack.
Absolutely. Ooh.
And this is Stephanie Camille, who, this is her first season of Art Battle, and this is her second time competing. In her first ever competition, she made it to the final, and is just such a new awesome artist that we've been exposed to this season that I'm really happy to have her back.
I also remember her painting, and she does use these beautiful pastels in jewel tones to create a wonderful portraiture. As you can see, it's already happening here.
Yeah, I love that she's chosen this like rich purple. I feel like there's so much opportunity to tone out this color. It lends itself well to that pastel application that you were talking about, and then she's getting deeper tones out of it as well. You know me, I love a good monochrome painting.
Yes, you do, because you're an expert. It's amazing. Yeah, it's really cool to watch, and you're right, this nice deep color really sets the groundwork for bringing in those pastels, or even whatever she ends up doing will be really expert level with this groundwork.
Okay, shifting over to Amanda McKagan. I think the last time that she painted an art battle was 2017, and she's definitely a fierce competitor.
Well, that's a long time ago. And it looks like she's got some really clean line work happening already.
I'm feeling Oh, I guess I don't have to worry about spoiling the surprise because we just saw her reference. But I was going to say, I'm feeling like it's some sort of moth or butterfly. And that's something that she incorporates a lot in her studio work as well. She often does these really intense, abstract backgrounds and then lays illustrative elements over top of that.
Oh, wonderful. Yeah, this is going to be a nice, clean lines, lots of black. So I'd like to see where this goes. There's no abstract background. Maybe it's going to come later. We don't know.
And here we are with Kristen Mulder, and she has painted in art battles all over the GTA. She's definitely a decorated art battle competitor with quite a few wins under her belt as well.
Very cool. What a cute little character, a little bunny. Oh, right, because Easter's around the corner. Didn't think of that. Lovely color.
I almost broke out into Easter song. I'm so glad I did it.
The Easter song. I wonder what that is.
Oh my God. I'll sing it to you on the break.
Okay, sure.
Loving the flow of colors here and the different spots that she's placing it, and that it's quite separated right now. She's not blending out the colors.
Yeah, it's a nice palette of color. Obviously, very Easter themed, but I'd love to see where this goes.
And the strong yellow in the background too. Mm-hmm. And here we are with Andrew Chetty-Sukra. He's an artist that we are familiar with as well, and I think it's been a little while since he's painted at Art Battle, but he is just such an epic artist. He's so he has such incredible technical ability, and he infuses that with this really unique emotional tone as well. He's one of my favorite Toronto artists.
I agree. I've watched his work for quite some time, and I've been following him online for some years, and his techniques are really beautiful, and his subject matter is going to also be beautiful today.
Even just looking at how he's laying out the composition, we've got a lot of dynamic composition going on right now.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
And speaking of dynamic composition, we've got some cool perspective going on with Nizreen.
Oh yeah, this is quite different from what I'm used to seeing from Nizreen. So this is cool for me to watch. such a good progress from the last time we were here.
And I love the way that she kind of has built this painting out. We had her do, or we first saw her doing the colors in the background with those horizontal strokes. And then she's used that as her sky, and it's kind of building forward.
Yeah, getting that layerability and setting her background is clever. I really like all of her angles here. They're really accurate, and getting a feeling of being drawn into that center point.
Especially with those few daubs of red. I'm wondering whether or not that's going to end up being taillights or something like that.
Yeah, I'm wondering what that will be too. Yeah, it's interesting. The skyline's really coming together.
And moving back over to... Oh, no, still with Nizreen.
Yep, we're not done. We're getting that palette moment. Painter sword. I said it. I said it before you said it. Yay!
Shout out to our other co-host Tyson, who loves to call the palette knife the painter's sword. Bonafide AB terminology.
He's got to copyright that before I get in trouble.
Oh, I love watching Randall just like vibing.
Yeah, he's having so much fun. And I think that's what Art Battle's about. Just getting up there and having fun and just painting your heart away. Look at this. It's coming together so well.
Yeah, I love that he has so, so much fun while he's doing it, but he's also still producing excellent work. Like, sometimes you see artists that get kind of caught in it, and that's always a good thing, but the work might suffer. But Randall's executing really well, and I think is just... this flourishing technique that he's got going on with his dance moves as well, as lending itself well to the painting.
Absolutely, yeah. You can definitely start dancing and get distracted. I think I did that on my first one. It was the music had me going. I started waving around. I was like, oh no, focus.
We do have good vibes, good music at our Battle Toronto. For anyone who's curious, we have DJ Shira on the ones and twos right now.
Yeah, she's really good. She got me dancing for sure. Oh, wow. Oh, wow.
A lot of progress from Stephanie on this portrait.
Yeah, she's brought in all those mid-tones. Oh, so nicely placed.
I just love how painterly this is. Like, there's so many brush strokes that are evident there, and you can just see like the individual hairs, and there's different levels of transparency, and yeah, I'm into this piece.
You're right, that painterly feel, I really admire people who can throw paint on a canvas, no matter how it's like they know how it's going to lay down before it lays down, and it still looks like paint. It's not like super blended. I really admire that. That's really impressionist style.
And those little hits of highlight, Be Still My Heart. My favorite moments are always the highlights.
Wow. This is just so nice to watch. The chin, there it is.
I know, I even love just watching her brush kind of search out and hesitate above certain areas before she places her brush stroke.
Yeah, it's her thought process, and it's just, obviously with a time limit, you can see it more. You can see what's happening in an artist's head based off of, you know, 9 minutes left on the clock, and she really has to think about where she's laying that brush.
Always, little moments like that just remind me of how special it is to get to see these guys painting live.
Oh, yeah. Look at this. This got drippy and cool.
Yeah, very inky. A lot of intentional dripping going on here as well, which is lending almost a bit of a creepy vibe, which I think goes well with the moss.
Yeah, I think that really does go well with the moth. I like the ones coming off the wings. It's really a nice little touch. It definitely goes with the subject matter.
And Amanda is also a stained glass artist too, which this piece reminds me of that fact, just seeing all of these cells within the wing, all these separated little compartments.
Yeah.
Just almost looks like little glass panels put together.
Right.
Oh, so fun from Kristen. I love that she's brought all of the colors from the character into the background.
Yeah, this is a really nice pop art looking style happening with that color in the background. You're right. It's so cool.
Oh. And there's something that's very intentionally kitsch about it that I like, that it's like leaning into that.
Right. Yeah. It's, I like it. I like it a lot. I didn't expect it. Didn't expect these layers of color to end up on the background as well.
And then I wonder what she's done here for, there's this like patterned brush stroke.
Oh, she's got some
cool stuff. We got.
What's that? Cool.
Oh, so fun.
Oh, pretty. That really does change it.
Yeah, it like tightens it up.
Mm-hmm.
This is very cool. I like this a lot.
Mesmerizing. Yeah, me too. I'm just staring. All right, we should be commentating.
We just kind of become mesmerized when we see a new technique. And I'm sure that the audience is also just getting really involved in this process now, the more that she's bringing out these surprise elements.
Yeah, it's like your jaw's dropping and you're just kind of staring for a while. But look at this, even the stamp that she's using here, like very like smartly placed, these little hexagon shapes.
And what amazing time management too for this. Like, she had to get all of her execution out of the way basically to then add these special elements. And she's got 6.5 minutes left on the clock and is bringing them out, and she just seems really relaxed while she's doing it.
Yeah, she came in with a plan, and I really respect that. Oh. Okay, I'm seeing a fighter jet on the top here.
Wow, this is stunning. And the perspective here, wow.
Wow.
Definitely a statement piece.
Mm-hmm. For sure. Ooh. And the water at the top looks really interesting too.
Yeah, that kind of watery element where we're seeing almost like bubbles. It's hard to describe, but it's like a web of color that's coming mm-hmm. down.
Like a drippy web. I also like that he brought this stick with him here. It helps with the angled lines that he's throwing in.
Oh, that's true.
That is so smart.
I was so absorbed with the painting, I didn't even recognize that he had brought his maul stick, and he's using it as a straight edge. Amazing. Yep.
Smart, smart. And he's got a nice sponge. It's going to give you nice texture. I'm really enjoying watching him paint all the different tools and techniques as well.
Yeah, it's interesting looking at how each artist is kind of approaching different innovative techniques. We've got Kristen, who wants to make her techniques very apparent. And then you have Andrew, who's using all kinds of different techniques, but he's blending them all and utilizing them in different ways to create like that harmonious element. You wouldn't know that they were unconventional methods. So it's always interesting to see how artists employ different methods, and especially checking out Nazreen here with this textured silicone wedge.
Mm-hmm. Those wedges are really handy, especially for something like Art Battle, where you can just throw down these amazing tons of windows on these buildings. Like, easy, right? Easy. So smart. And you can tell that Andrew and herself are both experienced Art Battle competitors just by seeing what they've brought to the table, tools-wise and technique-wise.
And even just Nazreen blending out those tail lights and bringing them forward with the perspective, a nice touch.
I agree. Oh, wow. Katie.
I love how he's done all of the flowers, and the butterfly also looks very floral. Like, the wings look like petals almost.
Yeah, I've got this almost like they're one thing, which they kind of are, which is really amazing. It's beautiful bouquet textures and spikes and leaves, and I just love all the different shapes and forms in his bouquet here, and it complements the butterfly really well.
Yeah, great, great expression of that kind of harmonious nature of nature.
Harmonious nature of nature, exactly. Yeah. Oh, goodness, look at that.
The addition of the pink in the background just sets everything off.
It really does. It's just brought it all to life. Wow.
And it's catching those little warm moments in the face too, like in the hollows of the eyes, and just a little touch of warmth in the lips and the eyebrows.
Mm-hmm. So clever and just, you know, professional. It's amazing. It's really amazing to watch. I love the hair texture. There's just a swoosh, a little swoosh of paint that gives you that impression of hair.
Exactly. It's not over-rendered.
Mm-hmm. I think that's what I enjoy about her work. It's just, like you said, not over-rendered. It is what it is. And she just knows how to use it properly.
Totally. And I think when you're working that way too, you have to be really, really good at proportion. Mm-hmm. And she's just hitting those proportions.
It really is.
Ooh, oh, way more color here from Amanda.
Cool. I love this dripping pink. I think that really just amplified her image.
Definitely. And I like that there's moments where it's muddy and like oily with the black ink, and then moments where it's just that pure neon. I think that's really interesting.
Yeah, I think I like that contrast as well. It's really fun to watch. Ooh. Seeing a drip come down. Very nice.
I love a good Art Battle drip.
Mm-hmm.
My favorite, though, I think is, I've seen it a couple of times, and it's so satisfying. It's when the timer counts all the way down, and the artist takes their brush off of the canvas, and the drip keeps going. even after the timer's cool. off. It's like such a delicious moment.
That's so cool. Oh, this bunny.
A lot of action in here.
Yeah, it's the textures, and there's also some dripping going on too that's creating more texture. Very cool.
Wow, just incredible from Andrew here. The warmth in the sky and like really this desolate, ominous feeling.
Yes, and he's adding this orange here to bring in some glow.
Wow, what an emotional piece.
Yeah, it's tough to talk about, but it is what it is, right?
And kudos to Andrew for taking this opportunity to share this piece with us.
Exactly.
Our countdown. 'd say that was a pretty epic first round for tonight's art battle in Toronto. Ariel, what do you think? What were your favorite moments?
Yeah, definitely epic. We've got so many different artists coming to the stage. I really enjoyed watching Nazreen use that little plastic scraper to get texture into the buildings. I think that was really clever. And the dripping going on in Amanda's painting, that was really cool. I mean, everyone had their own thing going on. Randall's always a party to watch, so that was fun and entertaining. So yeah, lots of different unique styles and hard to choose.
Yeah, some really great moments of technique. I think we also had some really emotive pieces with Andrew's piece. Stephanie's portrait also just was like emanating emotion for me. It's definitely going to be a really tough time to choose who should take this round. But now is your opportunity to vote as our viewers. So head to artbattle.com/AB2692 and cast your vote. The top two artists as voted by the audience will move forward into a third and final round with our top two artists from our next qualifying round. Round number two will begin in just a few minutes, and we'll have our next six artists stepping up to the easels, and they will also have 20 minutes on the clock. So stay tuned for round number two.
All right, my friends, last call if you want to be considered for the Sixth Easel tonight for our wild card. Last call.
All right, boys. Boys. And we are about to draw the name of the person who will rise from the audience into the roster of players tonight. Always a very exciting time. Sometimes it's someone who knows how to paint really well, sometimes it's just someone who's really brave. We'll find out what we're getting tonight. Are you going to pour them into that bag?
Simon's always with us.
All right. Here we go. We're drawing the wild card name now. Tanya is ceremoniously pouring the names into a small Simon's bag.
From the screen, but reminiscent of the other co-founder of our battle, Simon Plushies. So it all works. All right. Do you want to hold it and I'll reach in?
Yes, let's do it that way.
Can I get a drum roll, please? Is there an Alyssa Proctor in the building?
Oh, yeah.
Alyssa, I didn't know she was painting tonight, but...
Alyssa, you're at easel number six.
Yeah, see Luke over there?
Luke is right there. He has a...
Alyssa's cursor. Alyssa, can I ask you a quick question?
And finally, number six. She's been preparing for this moment for her entire life. She just found out she was painting 2 minutes ago. Give it up for Alyssa Proctor!
All right, we're going to count it down from five. Are you ready?
Welcome back, everyone, to Art Battle Toronto. We are here for our second round of the night. We have six artists up at the canvas and only 20 minutes on the clock. My name is Morgan Booth, and I'm here with Ariel Hosseini, who is an Art Battle vet herself. Hey, Ariel.
Hey, Morgan. Thanks for the shout-out, as usual. Okay, we've got busy hands already.
Jared is taking this seriously. That's maybe the most amount of paint I've ever seen go down on a canvas in 20 seconds.
That was 20 seconds. Yes, it was. And he's moving very quickly, and he looks super stern. So he's in the zone.
In the zone. We're also matching the outfit to the painting at this point.
Yeah, cool, cool.
Jared is prepared. And here we are with Tanya Murdoch. And fun fact about Tanya, she last painted in Art Battle 10 years ago, way back when we used to destroy the old unwinning paintings. So if a painting didn't win and it didn't sell, we would destroy it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, she sent in her application. Do you guys still destroy paintings?
Oh, she's probably had such a rush doing that. That must be
Yeah, we used to destroy them. One time we had a chainsaw. What? Another time we threw house paint on it.
Oh man, that's so liberating though. Especially if you're you're not into the piece as much. I mean, if you're into it, it's still liberating in its own way. Right?
Yeah, that was earlier days of Art Battle had maybe a little bit of Fight Club energy in them.
I see Fight Club / Art Battle part, right?
Oh, goodness. So good. Here we are with Dumas. Who I'm really interested to see paint tonight. I'm familiar with his digital work, but not so much his traditional media work. But I know that he has this real talent for mixing different unexpected colors and also expressing light.
Yeah, I know Daniel for his digital work as well. So it's really cool to watch how he will go about using these paint markers that he's using right now. And excited to see what's going to happen. I mean, if you can bring that glow in there, I would be really happy.
And getting really nice opacity with this Posca too.
Oh yeah, and Poscas dry pretty fast, so I think that's a good move.
Yeah. You know, I bet that Dumas has been practicing.
Oh, for sure. I mean, I feel like everyone definitely gets a moment at home to practice or to even just think about what they're going to do. But he's definitely using that marker like he knows what's going on.
So everyone's had an opportunity to practice in that they've been pre-booked, but this artist has not. Alyssa is our wild card artist, which means that we just drew her name out of the hat from the crowd. She signed up for a chance to paint, and here she is. Alyssa has actually painted with Art Battle in Halifax before as well.
Oh, nice. All right, so she does have some Art Battle experience, which is cool. It gives her a little upper hand as the wild card. And I'm seeing some nice soft colors in the background and giving a nice smooth transition there.
Yeah,
the
diffusion feels very watercolor to me.
Yes, exactly. Really fun. Watercolor is super fun. Morgan, you should definitely try it.
We were just talking about that off air and how terrified I am of watercolor.
It's a whole different game for sure. Oh, what's happening here? Very
this
bold.
This is Jared, and this is feeling a bit burgery to me.
Same. I was going to say that, but I wasn't sure. But I did see his previous work, and I'm having a feeling that this is a interestingly proportioned burger.
I feel like there's got to be some crazy twist that's coming with it too. Jared's work, I feel, can have a sense of whimsy. within it, and is definitely pop leaning. So I'm expecting that we're going to see something unexpected. I'm expecting the unexpected with Jared.
Unexpected. We'll never know. This burger might turn into a bird soon. You never know. Very cool.
And getting in there with a fan brush for those little glistening meat patty highlights.
Super highlights. Oh, wow. Look at this figure.
I love this.
Oh, wow. Yeah, beautiful choice of colors already, too.
The way that she's got the line work going on and the roundness that she's bringing to the figure, it reminds me of like French Fauvist painting, like a little bit like Toulouse-Lautrec, but much brighter and more vibrant.
Vibrance, yeah, the vibrancy is there. But that's that roundness is very sweet. It's very French, you're right. Oh, wow.
And I like that she's adding all of these little colors within her more dominant colors. We have this pink that's really loud here, but then she's toning it out just a little bit by adding some orange in there, and then she's got that lime green, and she's got just a hint of yellow.
Ooh, look at this beautiful, like, periwinkle blue. Oh, nice.
I'm loving this piece. I can't wait to see what color she brings into the figure.
Yeah, see, that's the thing with color. Like, you really need to understand it in order to throw this much on the canvas. You know, what will work between all of these three different colors here? Oh, I'm excited.
Ooh, and she's bringing that periwinkle into her shadow for the body.
Perfect. Makes sense.
And here we are with Cesar, aka Neuromantix, who is a muralist who's painted all over North and South America. So really stoked to have him here. I've been chasing him for a couple of months to get him up to the easel, actually.
Oh, no way. Okay, yeah, I am familiar with his work as well. Very cool. Lots of colorful choices in his mural work. Nice details as well. And I can see he's tackling a portrait here today.
And there's so much color going on in the center behind the line work of the face. I can't wait to see how he uses that within the tones of the face.
Yes, like, will he be covering it completely or using? I would love to see that he uses it for sure. I think he would. Nice.
And here we are with Jimmy Rice, who is a very prolific artist from Hong Kong.
Oh, wow, wonderful. For a second, I thought his shadow was his painting, and he was painting a portrait.
That would be so meta.
Yeah, it would. Oh, man, but it's looking... I love the style that he has right now going on. It's sketchy and confident strokes. I really like that.
And that hit of that greeny blue just sings over the orange and the yellow.
Yeah, that's a really beautiful choice of color. And I want to say it's a blue jay, but it could just be a blue bird. It all makes sense, though. It's really pretty.
I think you have it right with the jay.
Mm-hmm.
'Cause you've got that the sharper shape at the top of the head.
Mm-hmm. Little peak. I'm really, really loving the shape of this branch as well. It's so organic and crooked.
Yeah, that shape is so nice. And just into it. Some great shapes here from Dumas.
Yeah, he's going in with this very graphic style, using those Poscas to his advantage to create some dimension here. And yeah, the dry time for Poscas again is such a good choice for Art Battle.
I'm so here for it with the blue highlight on top of the red. That's so nice.
Very cool. Very, very cool. Yeah, and he's using it as almost like a shadow tone. And oh, very nice.
Oh, excellent. I wonder how he's going to treat the face.
Mm-hmm. Are we going to have just a figurative? I think it might just be a suggestion of everything.
And the way he's placed those highlight lines on the thighs just really kind of underline that roundness that he's getting across.
It's a good dimension. Oh.
So I've been looking through the Art Battle archives, and Alyssa is not only a previous Art Battle Halifax participant, but she's an all-star artist. So she has painted in many battles.
Okay, yeah. I mean, you can see she has some experience for sure. This is weird and cool at the same time.
I love that she wasn't prepared for this.
Yeah, this is awesome. I think it's a fish person?
Definitely a fish with like lady legs. So much fun.
Oh my god, what is happening?
It just gives me this massive smile.
Same. Wow, we were talking about this massive smile. Look at this.
Oh my gosh, so fun.
Oh wow, like executed really well. The dimension in the cheese, having that kind of see-through quality when it melts. Like, that's really cool little touch to me. And this burger looks like it might eat you.
I love it so much. The menacing burger and the eyes of Vidalia onions.
Yeah.
Perfect. Perfection.
Oh, man. We definitely knew something crazy was coming. We knew it.
This burger has presence.
Yep. Like, I eat you. You don't eat me.
This is a really fun round. I think that the artists are taking a lot of joy in the performance here.
I agree. Everyone's kind of on their own, creating something fun and unique and sticking to their style. And I really appreciate all the little highlights he's throwing in here.
Yeah, the highlights give it that glistening, appetizing quality.
Mm-hmm. The juicy burger.
Amazing. I love this so much.
Oh, wow. Yeah, so expressive and it feels, what's the word, mature.
And like, such thoughtful details, too.
It's so good.
Like, even though she hasn't separated the fingers on the hand that's on the floor holding the weight, you still definitely like recognize it as a hand.
Exactly, yeah. It's such a cool choice. It's a really nice style of art. Like, I don't think I've seen many things like it.
Yeah, I'm loving this piece. And then the gesture of the hand, and you can see it looks like it's got three fingers, but then when you look at the middle finger, there's just a teeny tiny notch of separation. Yep. There that's showing you that it's two.
Yeah. So cool.
This is such a painter's painting.
Yes. A painter's painting. That's a really good way to describe that.
Just makes me like nerd out about it.
Oh. And the expression on looking over the shoulder, I really love that. That face. That expression.
That's so good. Just the exaggeration and the like, the push and the pull of size too.
The toes, the feet, the hands, like such a cool way of executing that.
Ooh. Wow. Absolutely killing it.
Yeah, this is super moody now. Ooh, our favorite part, highlights.
And he's keeping them so soft at this point. Really nice.
Very nice. I love how he's blending. It's very subtle, the gradient change, but it's very nice.
Yeah, it's like underlining that glow quality that he's got going on just outside of the figure. And he's bringing that lighting technique into the face.
Sorry, I'm just mesmerized. Sorry.
I know. Same.
Talking.
Oh, my nose is about an inch from my screen right now.
Same. I'm so hunched over. Straighten your back, okay? No artist punch. Ooh, look at the birdie.
Yeah, Jimmy's doing such a great job. I love the little details that he's got going on in the feathers. There's just like small little lines that he's adding in to give us just a hint of texture.
Yeah, it's very subtle and it's highly effective, and the blue jay is popping out even more now that he's got these details in there. It looks really nice. I also really love the position of the feet, of the bird's feet.
Yeah, it's like an action pose. This isn't a passive bird painting. Like, it very much feels like this bird just landed.
Yeah, and it's just like trying to find its balance, trying to find its grip. Very cool.
Ooh, and just so careful in the details, and just using his pinky to rest to make sure that he doesn't smudge anything, like pro moves.
Very, very nice. Very pro, exactly. Nice. Oh, I want to see it without his shadow.
Part of the challenge of the live arena. That must be something that's challenging for him in the moment as well.
Yeah, because you've got to make sure that glare doesn't affect your entire painting. Oh, cute.
Yeah, I love the details that Dumas has put into the face.
Yeah, that really brings it together. And the hair detail as well. I really like that. Those fine lines are pulling the whole thing together.
And definitely pop culture nod with that little Basquiat crown.
Oh, yeah. I just saw it. Very cool.
And different highlights brought in as well with this like creamy pink color.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm seeing that. That's a really nice choice for highlight on this orangey, pinky red tone for the skin tone.
Mm-hmm.
It works really well. Like, good choice. Very good choice.
I think my favorite part of this right now is that the hair is mostly opaque, and then there's like a scribble line just on the outside of it, and you can see the canvas underneath it, and that like doodle quality is just, it brings a really interesting level of stylization.
Yeah, exactly. The stylism is brought in by the hair. That's what I'm feeling too. It's drawing me in quite a bit.
I just love it so much.
Oh my god.
So much fun.
This is great. It has little fins and lips and eyes and then human legs and heels.
And like, speaking of stylization, like, it's silly, but it's also really well done.
Yeah, it's so good. It's very well executed. And the subject is cool. Like, I don't think I've seen anything like that either. It's funny. And it's good to have a laugh.
We'll definitely be seeing Alyssa back at the easel this season, I'm sure.
Awesome. Oh, here's our hungry burger.
I love how grumpy he is.
Yeah, it's very grumpy.
such a menacing subject.
But again, just like our wild card, Jared is executing very well, even though the subject matter is hilarious. We've got some cool talent.
I would love to hear from anyone in the chat if they want to offer some suggested titles on any of the pieces in this round.
That would be fun.
All right, we've got just 2 minutes remaining on the clock, and voting is now open for our second round. And voting is still open for our first round, so make sure that you get in there and vote as well if you haven't. And you can do that at artbattle.com/AB2692. Also, all of the work created tonight is available for silent auction. You don't need to be in the room to collect these pieces. We will ship them to you. Stunning.
Stunning. That blue for shadow is just beautiful. I love that so much.
And that little step more of pink into the feet.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so good.
Wow, this is excellent.
Wow. Ugh.
These
are great.
We have our first title suggestion from none other than our Artbattle co-founder Simon Plashkes. He suggests Burger Beast for Jared's painting, which I think is absolutely fitting. I'm not sure we could call it anything else.
Yeah, I think that's perfect. That's awesome.
Wow. Caesar is just doing such a fantastic job here. I love all of these flourishing lines that he's doing at the last minute just to bring in a little extra movement.
Yeah, it's suggesting either, I think it's almost like a veil that's being put around it. It's very nice. It's so easy to throw it in and changes the whole thing.
And great light here from Jimmy.
Yeah, really cool. I love that the Blue Jay is in the center of this beautiful yellow glow, almost like a sunrise, sunset.
Get into the system. So, what I need you to do is go to the link that we sent you and re-click the link in your text message to open up the voting page again, and then vote for round one and for round two. Okay, so re-click the link. It may be a little slow because everybody's doing it at the same time. Get the system working as good as it can. But it may be a little slow, but what you need to do is re-click the link in the text message, opens up the voting page, and vote for round one and round two. All right, we will be monitoring the situation, and we'll let you know as soon as we have confirmed winners for round one and round two. A little complicated voting music, please, DJ Shara.
Another fantastic round of live competitive painting at Art Battle Toronto tonight. Our second round featured mostly new artists and two artists who had painted in Art Battle before. And I would say that all of them did a really great job and brought a lot of creativity and humor. There was a lot of humor in this round.
Absolutely. Like, really cool styles everyone's got and very unique thoughts. But yeah, I like the humor. I think that's really fun for Art Battle. It keeps people interested and keeps them wanting to see more from you as an artist.
Absolutely. And just some really fantastic, surprising moments as well. Caesar, I think, really surprised me with the way that he handled his colors tonight. I liked that he went for the green for the skin tone. I was not expecting that at all, and I thought it made for a really unique portrait. And Jared's Burger Beast, of course, was definitely another star, and Tanya just really brought it with that figure piece. So I think it's going to be a really tough time, as always, for us to choose which artist we think is best. So now is your opportunity to vote. Head over to artbattle.com/AB2692 to cast your vote. If you've been having any trouble casting your vote previous, that has been solved now. So go in there and cast your vote for both rounds one and round two. And when you're casting your vote, not only think about the visual representation of the piece and what piece you like the best, but also whose performance you enjoyed the most and who you want to see paint again. Because the top two artists from round number one and top two artists from round number two will move forward into a three artist final showdown. And we will be announcing our finalists in just a few short minutes. So stay tuned for that. I also want to take an opportunity to give another shout out to Ariel, who has quite a few shows coming up, I believe, as well. And you are definitely going to want to check out Ariel's work. You can see her Instagram link in the video description on YouTube, and she's at Dream Paint Art on Instagram. So definitely go check out Ariel's work.
Thanks, Morgan. That's very sweet of you. There's a couple shows coming up, a group show, a gallery that I'm going to try and submit to. Thank you so much for that.
Well, I'm excited. I'm excited about all these shows that you have going on, Ariel. And yeah, definitely go check out Ariel's work. And also, all of the artists featured in tonight's show all have profiles at that same voting link. So if you're curious about our competitors tonight and you want to learn more about them, you want to follow them on Instagram, you want to compare what their studio work is like versus their live art, go over and check out our bios that we have at the voting link. And oh man, I can't wait to see who makes it to the finals. Our final announcement coming up in just a few moments.